So Rocket Club is an after-school program focused on cultivating childpreneurs. They teach children at an early age about topics like NFTs, blockchain, and the stock market.
Joining us now with more are Aicha Sharif, Dean of Rocket Club, and her daughter, Cyrine. Thank you so much for both being here.
Oh, my gosh. Thank you guys so much for having us.
Explain to folks what Rocket Club is, because it really is a lot of things.
Absolutely. Rocket Club is actually an innovative after-school program that focuses on STEAM and entrepreneurship. The art in STEAM is using entrepreneurship as the art vehicle to deliver technology, science, and really topics that are cutting edge. And the creativity of entrepreneurship, we believe entrepreneurship is an art, and there's a lot of creativity and thinking process that goes into creating ideas and bringing them to market.
Oh, yeah.
And so we utilize that as a creative vehicle where the children can innovate, but at the same time, we Trojan horse in a lot of cutting edge topics like cryptocurrency and blockchain, the metaverse, biotechnology, NFTs, and the children are absorbing all of these materials because it's a lot of fun.
Fun, yeah.
Fun, but it's also complex if you think about it, because we've had several people try to explain to us what NFTs are, what the metaverse is. I mean,
we're just starting to understand it.
A little bit. I mean, are the kids able to absorb that?
Absolutely, and it's actually, when I started with the program, I was a little doubtful that the 7, 8, 9-year-olds would be into it. I was thinking, oh my gosh, this is amazing for middle school, high school children, and I was wrong. I actually started to feel that the 7, 8, and 9-year-olds are ideal for the program because they have no limiting beliefs and no self-doubt. Mm-hmm. So, you know, a lot of them want to be astronauts, or they aspire with space and rockets, so the name has rocket in it, but also we can teach them anything that we can gamify, and so we use a currency internally called rocket fuel, and we use it for participation, for them to ask questions, support each other, but we're also able to simplify the topics and use it in a project-based learning too. So when we talk about the metaverse, and Cyrine can speak about it a little bit, we asked them to create their own Decentraland, which is a world in the metaverse. And so, for example, Cyrine, she's in the program, and she can talk a little bit about it to see what she took away from that
module. Yeah, you also, on top of the metaverse, you also have a clothing line, and you're 7, or are you 8 now, 7?
I'm 7 and a half.
Seven and a half.
You gotta get the half in there, Amy. Yeah. You know better.
Yeah, tell us a little bit more about what you started.
Well, I started a company that was originally named Nature Sky, but now it's named BU. And on my t-shirt, I put the words Nature Sky on it because that's what my company was used to be named. And on the shirt, there's a picture of like the sky and it's wrapped in vines. And I made it related to Earth because I've been seeing a lot of trash on the Earth, and I don't really like that, and I want people to notice, and I want people to know that they shouldn't just care about themselves, and they should also care of what's around them, and like, what's most important.
And now, did you design all this in the metaverse?
No, designed it on an app called Canva.
Oh, okay.
All right, fantastic. Now, your mom was telling us, you can explain to us what the metaverse is.
Yeah, so a metaverse is a virtual reality game, and if it's all flat and it's like everything is like paper, then that means it's not a metaverse. But if it's 3D, then that means it's a metaverse. And it doesn't have to be like it doesn't have to be realistic. It can just be like a circle and an oval, and that can be your body for a person, and it doesn't even need to have legs.
I mean, the imagination, this is amazing.
Exactly, it's simple to them.
Yeah.
You can build a metaverse, and it basically just a shape. And when you look at some games, which are metaverses, like Minecraft, Roblox, the shapes are very simple.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
And so the creativity of the child doesn't think in a complex way. They just think about starting something that's fun.
Oh my goodness. And what have some of the children taken? Your daughter has started her own company. What are some of the other kids doing?
We've got children who've published their own books, because we do modules on e-publishing and creativity and writing. And we've got children who run their own stop motion company. We have Annabelle White out of New Jersey, who's been started with us when she was 7. And she started a motion stop motion company and ended up actually doing adverts for Bobby Brown and a few other companies that hired her to do it. And it started simple. She just loves to draw. And then she started moving the cards and putting them together. And before you know it, it starts evolving. And that's what we tell the parents and the children, don't worry about what they can take away from it. Let them start and let them pursue that journey of changing their mind. So it's interesting because we were in the green room and we met John, and he's a published author. Mm-hmm. Started talking about his book, and she grabbed my laptop and started writing her book. And it's, what's the book called?
The Pug Who Thought He Was a Goose.
The Pug Who Thought He Was a Goose.
That's so cute. Look at that. And that just came from a simple conversation.
It's inspiration.
That is so wonderful.
We wrote chapter one, and we started doing some illustrations in Canva, which is a design software that she learned. And now, maybe next week we do chapter two.
Right? And I love how you said it. It's like a Trojan horse. You just drop it in. That is fantastic. All the information on Rocket Club Academy is right there on your screen. Social media handles and the website as well.
Thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you so much for having us.
This is amazing. Inspiring the next generation. We need it.
All we know now is what we don't know.
Exactly.